A new report is once again highlighting failures in Alberta's foster care system. The report focuses on the death of Samantha Martin, a 13-year-old girl who spent most of her short life in foster care. James Hees reports.
Samantha was just 7 weeks when her parents agreed to put her into foster care. She had been diagnosed with a chromosome disorder.
We were informed that our daughter would not walk, talk, possibly know who we even were.
Velvet Martin says the family was new to the province and didn't have health care, and a government worker told her the province wouldn't pay for Samantha's treatment unless she was in foster care. That became a nightmare.
Facial bruising at one point from the top of her eye to her chin without explanation. 7 broken limbs.
Martin says she was eventually told she didn't have the right to see her daughter, and she asked the government worker to check up on Samantha.
The caseworker said to us, "I can't find placements for children less disabled than Samantha. Basically, don't rock the boat."
Eventually, the child advocate stepped in. Samantha came home 12 years after being placed in foster care.
Within the summer months, she had gained 12 pounds, not eating any differently from her siblings.
But Samantha died a short time later. It took Velvet 2 years to have the government agree to a fatality inquiry. The report documents some of the problems and recommends such things as required annual checkups and reasonable caseloads for workers. The NDP's Rachel Notley says that's not good enough.
We need a system where these kinds of things are not, as a matter of course, swept under the rug.
The government today responded outlining new policies since Samantha's death. It says it's monitoring workloads and will examine this report closely. But there's no mention of new penalties for workers who don't properly protect children in foster care. Velvet Martin says there should be.
I don't want to see another child die. I don't want my child's life and death to be in vain. This needs to stop.
James Hees, CBC News, Edmonton.